for some strange reason. We're unsure, you know, what happened. We may not ever know what was going through Sue's mind at that particular time.
NBC2 is learning more about a world-renowned skydiver who died in Hendry County. Sue Sweetman tried to pull her parachute Saturday during a jump, but it malfunctioned and she fell to the ground. NBC2's Jennifer Vaglis is live in Clewiston tonight at the Skydive Spaceland facility. And Jennifer, Sweetman was no amateur. I mean, she'd done more than 6,700 jumps.
Yeah, so Kelly, a close friend of Sue Sweetman tells me she didn't only jump out of planes for fun, she also competed professionally in formation skydiving. That's what brought her here to this airport on Saturday afternoon, where she tragically lost her life.
A bright light in the skydiving community with a one-of-a-kind talent gone too soon.
And she was just a really valuable person to have, very solid individual.
Today, skydivers across the globe are heartbroken and confused after 65-year-old Sue Sweetman lost her life doing what she loved the most.
For some strange reason, we're unsure, you know, what happened. We may not ever know what was going through Sue's mind at that particular time.
Saturday afternoon, Sweetman visited the Everglades Airport in Clewiston to practice a skydiving formation with six others through Skydive Spaceland.
I was doing my normal stuff here and running the operation.
Rick Hornsby says the first trip went up smoothly, but when the group went for a second jump, Sweetman experienced something that statistically only happens in one out of every 1,000 jumps. Her primary parachute malfunctioned. By the time she tried to deploy her backup parachute, it was too late. Hornsby saw the grim result.
Just very traumatic at that time.
Tonight, her teammates turned friends reflect on the legacy she's leaving behind.
She had four-way medals. I think she had several of those. She had one or two, if not more, eight-way medals. She had quite a few record jumps.
And her dazzling personality.
She was very outgoing, and she would be the first to say she was loud.
Now, friends tell me that she was known as Florida's very own Jersey girl, and people just love to be around her for her sarcastic attitude and her cackle that just absolutely captivated a room.